Welcome. In the last demonstration, we saw how to draw a stone with layers of jagged edges. So essentially, we saw how to draw something like this. And here you can see that we have different layers and these are jagged edges. And the stones essentially have that characteristics. So what we will do in this demonstration is to see how you can use the same technique to draw mountains. So essentially, you know, like I've shown previously, you know, the mountains and stones, they share very similar techniques in the sense that, you know, many of the techniques that we use for drawing stones, you know, they can be applied for the mountains. And we have seen some other examples of that before. So what I will do in this demonstration is to show, you know, how the technique that we saw in the last demonstration for drawing the stones with jagged edges can be used to draw a mountain as well. So what I'm doing over here is, you know, I start by, you know, laying down my outline of the mountain in dotted in line. So essentially, you know, in this technique, we want to tuck the planes in. So it's always good to have this in the dotted, you know, line so that you can then essentially, you know, create the appropriate ending that you want for your layers. So once we have that, you know, essentially what we'd simply do is you start to, you know, bring down these lines. So essentially these define the kind of, you know, the jagged edges and the layers, you know, that we will have for our mountain. So what I will do essentially is to, you know, again, you know, do the these lines in a very similar manner that we did for our stone. So essentially, you know, keep these lines interesting. So essentially, you know, what we want is a line, you know, something that has this kind of shape, because this is the kind of, you know, the edge that you will have. And this is much more interesting than having a simple, you know, straight edge like this. So always try to have, you know, more interesting shapes for the edges that I'm doing over here. And then we can bring it down from the other side as well. And you can also vary the size. So essentially I have, you know, one small edge over here, and then I'm, you know, increasing. But if you want, you can come back and add a small edge over there as well. So, you know, just adding these different, you know, shapes and sizes of edges, you know, make it overall interesting. And then over here, then I can come back and add one more plane. So the technique is very similar. You know, so we start by laying out the outline of our mountain, and then we come back and, you know, add these lines, which will convert them into a plane in a moment. And that will, you know, create this layers of jagged edges that, you know, we did for our stones. And now we will have a mountain with the same theme. And again, this, you know, this technique is very flexible. So for example, if I want, I can come back and add a small layer over here, or some, another edge over here. So this is very flexible. That's something you can play with. And that's what I really like about this technique, is that it really helps, you know, just have, you know, spur of the moment creativity and be able to add different lines and, you know, create these kind of edges and these layers that we will see in a moment. So essentially what I can do at this point is, you know, go ahead and, you know, add a few more lines. And again, you know, you can either make, you know, a lot of extensive, you know, layers, or you can have, you know, few big layers, things like that, right? So this totally depends on your thinking and your approach, right? So for different, you know, people, you know, some people might have, you know, more interest in having a different layers, multiple layers, a lot of layers with small, you know, edges, whereas, you know, other hand, you can go ahead and have, you know, a few layers with long edges. So this is it's a very creative, you know, flexible technique. And let me just draw this bottom as well. So, and once we have these kind of, you know, lines defined, what we do next is to essentially, you know, again, you know, start by laying down this parallel line that will help them convert these edges into a plane. So again, you know, the technique is to essentially start at a point, right? So essentially, when you're converting these lines into plane, you essentially, you know, start at this edge, you leave, you know, start from here as a point, and then you increasingly, you know, add these parallel lines to convert those lines into a plane, and there you have it. And as I explained, you know, so if you take this line as an example, anytime the line turns inward, so this is our point of view, so anytime the line goes this direction, then we cannot really add a parallel lines, because this plane is essentially not facing the viewer. So we essentially add parallel lines for all the planes, all the area of line that is facing the viewer. And again, over here, this is not facing the viewer, so we leave this, and then we again, you know, continue adding lines like this. So essentially, you know, we are adding lines, you know, parallel lines to create a plane wherever that plane will be essentially visible to the viewer. And we will do the same, you know, over here as well, right? So I'll start by essentially, you know, converting that line into a plane by adding these parallel lines over here, something like this over here. So there we have it. So now this is how easily you can, you know, convert that line into a plane by adding this parallel line. And I'll do the same on the other side over here as well, over here, and these lines as well. So as you can see, you know, this technique is very flexible, very interesting technique, and it really creates, you know, mountains and stones with very interesting, you know, characteristics. So they have these nice, you know, edges, and they have these different layers, right? So that gives it a very appealing look. So, and I really like this technique, and as I said, this is very flexible, and, you know, you can easily, you know, add planes anywhere you like. The other thing to keep in mind is that we also want to tuck in these planes. So essentially what we are saying is that, you know, this plane goes around and goes inside of this other plane. So something, so what you do is essentially, you know, if you have one plane something like this, and you have a line like this, then you have to bring it back inside of here, and then this plane will extend a little bit outside. So essentially what is happening at this plane, now this plane will essentially get hidden behind that other layer that is, you know, coming out of it. So that's what we have to do. So essentially that's what we do over here. So that's why we know it's good to have this in a dotted line. So essentially once you have defined these lines, then what you can do is you can essentially, you know, create those layers over here. So what I do is over here, you know, I come back and, you know, essentially darken this spot to make this plane, you know, disappear behind this other plane at the top. So that's what we do. Essentially this is how, you know, we can easily create the layers. And at this point I'll come back and, you know, essentially convert this line into a plane as well. And again, the length of line will decide, you know, how deep your plane is, for example, right? So if you want to really make a deep plane, what you can do is, you know, essentially have one big, you know, plane, and that will give a very different feel. And over here, again, I will come back and, you know, add one small plane over here. And again, you know, the planes, these lines can be in very interesting shapes, right? So this line is going a bit downward, so you have a plane, you know, that is going down compared to this other plane that are going, you know, flowing on this in this direction. So essentially, you know, by using these lines in different directions and making them flow in different ways, you can have a very, very interesting shape for your mountain. And then I'll go ahead and, you know, again, convert this line into a plane as well over here. And as you can see, you know, as this line goes inside over here, you know, I decrease the length of my parallel lines. So essentially my plane is kind of, you know, going inside and is kind of, you know, less visible from there. And the other thing I do is to also again go back and tuck in, you know, my plane behind. So this I extend it a bit outwards, something like this. So there you have it, you know, you can easily, you know, use this technique to create a mountains with very interesting shapes. And over here, and it's always also good to have a bit of, you know, smaller kind of these planes at the top of the mountain that always adds, you know, more interest. What I'll do is again, you know, go ahead and just add a few more over here, a few more smaller ones over here, something like this. So this always adds more interest. So there we have it, something like this. And at this point, you know, if you want, you can have, even have more smaller planes, something like this. So essentially, you know, again, you know, I can just easily add. So the other thing that you can also do is to essentially add just a plane on the surface as well. So essentially, you know, what we have done is to essentially bring down these planes from the side. But if you want, you can essentially draw a line like this. And the techniques to, again, you know, start at a point, use this, but then you also have to end at a point. So essentially, any plane that is in the surface of the mountain, it will again, you know, start at a point and also end at a point. Over here, you know, our planes on the edges, they go and flow back into this plane. But essentially, on the surface of the mountain, you have to start and end at a point, and that this way you can also define the planes on the surface of the mountain. So there we have it. And what I will do is again, you know, go back over here and add some convert this line into a plane as well. And at this point, you know, again, I can add a few more. So essentially, this is very, you know, organic approach, right? So as you are drawing and you feel that, you know, there is more white and you would like to convert, take away some white and create a plane, you know, you can easily do that by adding a line over there. And I'll go ahead and, you know, again add a bit more over here to convert this line into a plane over here, something like this. And I will do the same. And at this point, if I want, I can make a bigger plane for this one. So as you can see, what I did was, you know, bring down the line more, and that, you know, made a plane that is much more deeper, you know, this one compared to the other plane. So this is, you know, something that you can easily play around with, and if you want, you can make a much more deeper plane, you know, compared to, you know, other planes. So essentially, you know, making these variations and making these things, you know, different, you know, adds overall interest to your mountain. And then I'll go ahead and, you know, add a bit more plane over here, and I will do something similar over here as well. So here you can see, you know, because this plane is going up, you know, I only added my parallel lines till here, and then this plane goes and then it gets hidden behind over here. And again, I will go ahead and, if at this point, let me just bring down one more line. I'll tuck this plane behind this other plane, and I will again, you know, make this a small plane, something like this over here. And over here, like I said, you know, it's always good to add some planes at the top of the mountain. So that's what I will do over here. So I'll go ahead and just add one more over there and one small plane over here. So there we have it. So no, this is now our, you know, the shape is not turning, you know, beginning to look like a mountain. And the other thing I always do is to again, you know, come back and tuck those planes, right? So essentially, I take away and, you know, take and bring it inside, and then my other plane starts from this. So this way, you know, you create those layers, you know, that adds visual interest to the mountains. And over here, I will go ahead and, you know, do something similar. I'll just go ahead and create that plane, and over here as well. So as you can see, you know, anytime the line goes inside, you know, I don't really choose parallel lines because that plane is not visible to me. And anytime the plane is facing the viewer, then we add those lines to essentially indicate the visible plane. And then I will go ahead and, you know, do the same thing over here. So there we have it, right? And at this point, you know, if I want, I can have one more bigger plane over here, one smaller plane, something like this, right? So again, you know, I can easily add in, you know, a few more planes just to, you know, make the overall mountain more interesting. Something like this over here. And this one, I can give it more interesting shape and just again, you know, bring it down and make it something like this over here. So now you can see, you know, this is how easily you can, you know, create these mountains. And this has a very interesting feel to it. You know, this has this kind of nice jagged, you know, layered feel that, you know, gives much more interest compared to the other, you know, just being a mountain with a flat surface. And what I can do over here is, so again, you know, just add a bit more over here, something like this, something like this. So always, you know, you can add the top of the mountain, you know, more interesting, because that's where the viewers, you know, eyes, they travel the mountain and they usually go and rest at the top of it, right? So making the top interesting, you know, with the smaller planes and cuts like these, you know, they always adds to the interest. And at this point, I will go ahead and again, you know, do the same over here, and then I will do this something else over here. So here, as you can see, what we have is actually a fork. So I, you know, had a line like this, and then I have another line that goes down like this, right? So essentially, we have this kind of plane over here, and then another plane over here that is a kind of, you know, fork from that original point. So it's, you can always, you know, try that as well. That also adds quite a lot of visual interest to the mountains. Now I'll go ahead and add a bit more over here, a bit more of plane over here. And again, over here at the top, let me just add a few more planes, you know, just to make it a bit dark and give it a bit more interest, something like this over here. At this point, like I said, you know, if this plane is looking a bit kind of, you know, white and there isn't a kind of, you know, plane, then you can simply again, you know, add it over here, something like this. And then I will again convert this line into a plane. So this is how it is, you know, essentially you can, you know, creatively add, you know, any planes to give the mountains a no more interesting shape, something like this. So now you can see, you know, just by adding this, you know, planes, we have converted, you know, that outline into a very interesting mountain that have this successive, you know, layers of, you know, jagged edges, something like this. And what I will do so is essentially go back and reinforce those layers. Essentially what I'm doing is, you know, the lower layer goes back inside and the upper layer comes out, something like this. So that gives it, you know, very nice feeling of layers. And then I'll, again, this is one more, I will do it over here as well. And then I do the same techniques to essentially kind of, you know, create those layers over here as well. And the last thing that we will do is to essentially kind of, you know, put some texture on the flat surfaces of these, of the mountains. So essentially, you know, what we are doing in this technique is to create those, you know, layers of these layers, right? So but, and this is the flat, this is the horizontal surface we have, and what we want to do is to again, you know, give it some kind of texture. And as you saw in our stone tutorial, what I did in my stone tutorial is to essentially use these parallel lines, you know, to create some kind of texture. And we can do this something similar for the mountains as well. So what we can do over here is to essentially, you know, use these parallel lines to indicate, you know, some indication of the slope of these mountains. So essentially what I'm doing is to use these parallel lines, and the angle of these lines, you know, will indicate some kind of, you know, indication of the slope of the mountain. And also what we will do is to add a few more things to essentially, you know, convert it into a nice texture. So there we have it. Just by adding these, you know, lines, as you can see, you know, this is giving us a nice feel for the mountain. And essentially it is also, what happens is that these lines, they indicate the horizontal plane. So essentially, you know, over here we don't really have any indication of the horizontal plane, so our eyes can make out that there's some kind of plane, but it's not explicitly represented, you know. So it kind of, you know, feels a bit vague and it looks more like snow covered. So essentially, if you have, you know, a feel for a snow covered mountain, then you can leave it like this. But otherwise, it's always good to essentially come back and essentially use these parallel lines. As you can see, you know, when I add these parallel lines, what it does is that it gives a more firmer definition to that plane, and it, you know, brings it out more. So that's something that you can always do, and, you know, add more interest. So what I will do is do something very similar over here for my other planes as well. And again, you know, by using the angle of these parallel lines, what you can do is to essentially, you know, convey the angle of the mountain. So essentially here, you know, this is sloping something like this, this is sloping something like this. And over here, what I can do is to essentially, you know, use a lines in this manner to indicate a bit more of a slope. So essentially by changing the angle of the lines, you can have a, you know, a very nice definition of the slope of your mountain as well. So that's a very interesting thing that you can use as well to give it even more effect. So for example, over here, if I want, you know, I can use a line in this manner, something like this. So now, you know, we have a more clear understanding of, you know, the way the mountain is, you know, kind of sloping, and that always, you know, also adds more interest. So now, you know, as you can see, just by adding these parallel lines, you know, we have a nicer definition of this, you know, the slope of the mountain. So essentially now what we have is a combination of these, you know, these distinct planes and the, and some nice indication of the slope of these planes, which, you know, gives us a nice overall feel for our mountain. And so, and again, you know, for example here, you know, what I can do is I can, you know, add a line like this. So now this is giving it slope of this kind to that area. And over here I'll come back and again, you know, add a parallel line like this. And over here I can, you know, add a parallel line like this. Essentially, just by using these lines in different directions, you know, you can really, you know, add a good definition of the way, you know, the overall mountain is sloping or is structured. So there we have it, right? Something like this. And then finally, what I will do is again, you know, add a bit more line over here just to, you know, indicate that mountain sloping in that direction, something like this, and over here, something like this. So there we have it. So this is, you know, how you can easily create these, you know, interesting mountains, and essentially, you know, create those interesting, you know, overlapping planes, and at the end, you know, come back and add these parallel lines to give it, you know, even more firm definition of, you know, its horizontal planes as well. So over here, for example, you know, I want to just indicate that these are planes, these are not sloping too much, and I just simply add this line. But here I want to indicate that this is a much more sloping plane, then I will add a line like this. So now here we can see that, you know, this is, you know, this seems like a more of an incline, and these are a bit more horizontal. So this way, you know, you can easily add kind of different angles to your mountains, and that makes it much more interesting. So there we have it, you know. So this is how you can easily create these kind of, you know, mountains with jagged overlapping edges. And one last thing that you can also do is and also come back and add a bit more texture or a bit more kind of, you know, feel to these horizontal areas. So essentially, you know, like I said, you know, explained in my demonstration of this for a stone, you know, if you want, you can just leave it like this, or you can always, you know, add a bit more interesting kind of, you know, texture over at this horizontal plane. So if you want, you can, you know, come back and essentially, you know, kind of define these freestanding planes and then use this parallel line, right, something like this, to essentially create a planes over there as well. But some many times it's just, you know, adequate to come back and just add a bit more ticks and things like that, that will indicate a bit more roughness. So that's something that you can do. So it's very similar to the stone, right? So what you want to essentially have a bit more indication of the roughness. And again, you don't make it uniform. So what I'm doing is to just essentially, you know, kind of just, you know, moving my hand. If I want, I can add a bit of, you know, kind of darkness, something like this over here, something like this. So this will, you know, so essentially, you know, again, just move your hand like this, you know, bit up something like this in different direction. So this indicates a kind of, you know, surface roughness, something like this. So I just, you know, move my hand and, you know, just indicate, you know, these ticks and marks over on the surface. And that gives it a bit more, you know, interesting feeling and gives, you know, it essentially creates, you know, some additional plain, small, you know, kind of indentations or, you know, crevices or things like that on these surfaces and makes it more interesting. So that's what I will do, is to simply come back and, you know, just wiggle my hand. Essentially what you're doing is, you know, leaving and then just wiggling your hand, something like this. But remember, do not make it into a square shape. So this square shape is not in the perspective. In perspective, you know, it will start at a point, then wiggle, and then end at a point, or something, a shape like this, you know, a shape. Something like this, you know, this is the kind of shape that you want to add your crevices and other things in. So that's what I do, and essentially I just start at a point and it slowly increase and wiggle and then end. So there we have it, or something like this. So essentially, you know, just add a bit more wiggles and things like that, and also always also try to add them in the direction of your plane. So for example, if my plane is going like this, it's always, you know, more interesting to add them in this direction. So this is what I'm doing now, just adding them in more in the direction of the line. So essentially we're going with the direction of the plane to add our those crevices and other marks. There we have it, something like this. And at the top, what you can always do is to also always add a kind of vertical dark, something like this. So this indicates a kind of, you know, cut and something like, so something like, you know, this over here. So this indicates a bit of, you know, cut and a dark area, you know, comprised of that cut, you know, always adds more interest. So something like this over here, like this. So you can always add that over here, and then what I can do is I can go back and, you know, again, but this always has to be in a tapered manner as well. So that's what I did over here, something like this. And then I'll go back and again, you know, add a bit of crevices over here, a bit of crevices over here, something like this, or a bit even, you know, something like this. So there we have it. So now you can see, just by adding a bit more crevices and dots, you know, this mountain acquires a bit more interesting, you know, character. And something like this I will do over here. And so again, you know, try not to overdo it. You know, essentially, you do not want to, you know, overwhelm this hole with so much of crevices and marks that, you know, those planes that they lose their identity. So essentially, what you want to do is to, you know, have a bit, you know, of those marks and crevices here, a bit over there. So in the end, you know, what we have is a nice distinct feel of this kind of layered mountain with, you know, these kind of planes, and then we have a nice indication of, you know, the orientation of these planes using these horizontal lines, and then finally these crevices and things like that, they add a, you know, bit more interest and gives us, you know, a nice feeling of these mountains, you know, by defining this additional kind of, you know, roughness on their surface. So there we have it. So this is how, you know, you can use the same technique to essentially, you know, create the mountains. And the last thing you can do is to always come back and add a bit more kind of darkness to the edges as well. So, you know, so what happens sometimes is that if you have an edge that is very flat, then what you can do is to come back and just make it a bit dark in a tapered manner, and that, you know, gives it a bit more interest as well. So that's what I can do. So essentially, you know, wherever there's a simpler edge, you know, so for example, if you have an edge something like this, then you can come back and just add a bit of taper darkness over here, a bit of taper over here, something like this over here, and that gives an, you know, edge a more interesting feel. So that's what I will do, you know, but just add a bit over here, a bit over there, and there we have it, right? So this is now kind of a nice mountain with this kind of layered, you know, jagged planes, and a nice feel to it. One last thing that I wanted to point out is the difference between this mountain that we drew and this earlier mountain that we have shown in this demonstration. So essentially, you know, in this demonstration, we have seen how you can create these layers. And in this earlier demonstration, what we did was to essentially create these kind of jagged edges of the same mountain. So the difference is, you know, in the earlier approach, what we did was to we create this kind of, you know, staircase in a way, outline. And then what we did was to essentially, you know, from wherever there's a change in the angle, we brought a line down, and then we essentially, you know, converted that line into a plane. So this process of converting that line into a plane is similar to how we did over here. The difference is that in an earlier approach, now in this approach, what we did was to essentially, you know, start by defining this kind of outline. And what we did was to essentially, you know, bring down the lines like this from wherever there was a change in plane, changing the angle, and then we essentially created this kind of, you know, staircase kind of mountain, you know, this kind of approach. Over here, what we did was to essentially, you know, create a different kind of outline, and then essentially we, you know, we just brought down a line, you know, from wherever point that we liked, and then essentially then tucked those planes inside to create a kind of layered approach. So this is different in a sense that the technique of converting, you know, drawing a line and then converting that line into a plane is similar. But what happens is that in this approach, what we are doing is essentially, you know, bringing the lower plane inside and then extending the plane above it a little bit outside. And this is creating this kind of, you know, staggered layers over here. Whereas in that earlier approach, you know, we have a feel for the same mountain, but with different kind of, you know, edges over here. So that's the difference. So this is a different feel, but overall, you know, the overall approach is that, yeah, you're having this kind of, you know, vertical edges, and then you're having this horizontal plane. So it's a combination of the vertical edges and horizontal planes. Essentially over here, you know, these are kind of, you know, staggered, you know, kind of approach, kind of, you know, staircase approach. Whereas over here, what we did was to essentially, you know, tuck in the planes to create a more of a layered feel, you know, something like this over here. So this is in a different approach and essentially gives a different feel. But yeah, you know, you can experiment with both, you know, watch both the demonstrations and play with both those techniques and see, you know, how you can draw these mountains effectively and, you know, essentially bring out these characteristics. So the main characteristic is kind of, you know, these different planes that are layered and essentially, you know, have these horizontal planes that, you know, gives it a nice interesting feel. So there we have it, you know, and at the end, you know, if you want, you can always, you know, add something at the bottom. So essentially, you know, I won't do it over here, but essentially, you know, what I like to do is to always create a kind of, you know, ground cover over here, right? So you can easily create a ground cover and a transition point. So the easiest way is to draw a kind of, you know, a distant tree line. So that's what I think I will do very quickly. So you use these horizontal lines and you create a distant tree line, and that acts as a nice transition point between the mountain and the ground. And the way we do a distant tree line is essentially uses, you know, vertical lines. So we have seen this in a lot of demonstrations. So just by using these vertical lines, you know, and what we can also do is to essentially make them a bit darker at the base. So by using these, you know, vertical lines, you create a nice distant tree line, and that acts as a nice transition point between the ground and the mountain. So let me just add a few more. And so this is how, you know, you can easily create, you know, yet another type of mountain. So in my other demonstrations, I've shown how to create mountains in quite different ways. And like I've said before, you know, mountains are very interesting in that, you know, they come in a great, you know, variety of shapes, sizes, and, you know, textures and different feel. So it's always good to, you know, learn different techniques of doing them, right? So this is yet another technique. And at this point, you know, you can simply add a bit of grass over here, a bit of grass over there. But yeah, so essentially, you know, try to learn all those different techniques that I have for mountains in my mountain playlist. And over there you will see that, you know, I've shown, you know, quite different ways of drawing mountains, and they all give a very different feel. So over here you can see that the mountain has a very different feel of, you know, staggered, you know, edges. And yeah, now in my playlist I show, you know, how you can create mountains that have a kind of, you know, smooth feel, a bit of, you know, surface textures. Or over here, you know, we have a mountain that has a bit more of jagged layers. And then we also have a demonstration where I show how you can create mountain with successive rounded forms. So essentially, you know, those are different ways, you know, look at those demonstrations and see how you can draw mountain in many different ways. So there we have it, you know, a very simple nice way to draw a mountain with this layer of jagged edges that gives a real nice and interesting feel. And again, the process is very kind of, you know, evolving. So essentially when you're drawing it, you know, you don't really have to start with any fixed outline. You just start by, you know, putting down your outline something like this, and then essentially you just bring down a line from wherever you feel like it, and then convert those lines into planes, and there you have it. Thanks, take care, bye-bye.